Fireside Chat.
Please welcome Mr. Steve Brown.
Here while I was doing that. It's good.
All right. So, Steve, you got a pretty good
story about how you got started yo-yoing.
Yes.
Because you have not yo-yoed your entire life.
No. I started playing with yo-yos when I was 19 years old because I was homeless and needed a job. And I, of all the places that I was walking around putting in job applications, the one that actually took me seriously for the briefest of moments was a kite store. And they sold yo-yos and juggling equipment. And the owner basically said, well, if you can juggle and yo-yo, well, I'll give you a job. So being 19, stupid as a rock and indestructible, I said, I'll learn. 18 years later, I'm taking off my pants for you.
Did you also learn that at the kite store?
Actually, I had learned that just the year prior.
Oh, okay, wow.
It was a college town, a lot of experiences.
You're definitely the only person I've ever heard who started a career in yo-yoing because they were homeless and didn't have a job.
Yeah.
Generally, it's the other way around.
Yeah. You know? Yeah. Usually, yeah, you start the career in the variety arts, end up homeless, and then, you know, try and get that pizza delivery gig or something.
Yeah. Well, so speaking of gigs, I know that you have traveled literally around the world doing yo-yo gigs.
17 countries and counting.
Wow.
Yeah.
Even America.
Yeah. Yeah. So, the passport was the point where my parents actually started to think maybe I wasn't lying about this.
So in your travels, do you have a best gig? And was it overseas?
Actually, my best gig was in New York. It was at the Pussycat Lounge in New York City. I was doing a variety show in the second floor of a strip club.
For children.
It was a bar mitzvah.
Yeah.
No, but like downstairs was the strip club, and then upstairs they had this second stage, and they weren't using the area. So some friends had rented it out, and we're doing like an old school, like New York style variety, like variety vaudeville show. And so I did a set, and all the girls that were working downstairs would get bored and come upstairs to watch the show. So I came out and I was doing a routine to Poison, Nothing But a Good Time.
Good stuff.
So I've got like 20 off-duty bored strippers cheering and yelling, take it off!
Were they dressed like this?
While you were yo-yoing?
While I was yo-yoing. I'm like up there like yo-yoing. And I'm, you know, doing like power slides and everything. And so I strip down to my underpants and I'm still yo-yoing. And then these strippers start putting dollar bills in my underpants. I made $17.
That is fantastic.
I'm the first guy to walk out of a strip club having turned a profit.
We've set a new bar right here. Steve Brown, ladies and gentlemen. And I know that you're an incredibly busy man. Every time I talk to you, it seems like you've got another amazing project that you're working on.
Yeah, I've got a few.
The one that still blows my mind is 365yoyotricks.com.
Yeah, that one's been...
Can you give a little description of what that is?
In 2011, I've been a professional yo-yo demonstrator now since 1996. And the thing is that now that I've got these awesome kids in the front row who are laughing their butts off every single thing, Maverick and Trixie, they eat up a lot of my time. And I'm cool with that, but it doesn't leave me a whole lot of time to be the same, like, selfish, idiot 20-year-old kid who can just, like, yo-yo for 15 hours a day. So I was kind of missing, like, the amount of, because I really did used to yo-yo, like, 10, 12 hours a day. Like, it was crazy when I first started. So I was kind of missing that creativity. So I started up a project, and, you know, the surest way to make sure you follow through on anything is to publicly announce it, because then everybody's going to hold you to it. So I basically announced that in 2011, every single day, I was going to create a yo-yo trick, film it, and put it online.
Every single day.
Now, the smart guy would have made a bunch in advance and then just...
Nope.
No, every single morning, I woke up with a blank slate, created something completely from scratch, filmed it, edited, put it online.
I mean, that's shocking. I've been yo-yoing for 25 years, and I've made up a few tricks, but, I mean, maybe enough to count on one hand. And you've made up 365.
Well, and that was in 2011. In 2012, I decided I needed to take a little time off. So I cut myself down to three tricks a week, and then brought in some friends to fill in the rest of the space so that we'd have a little more variety. So that was, you know, another, like, 100, it ended up being like about 130, 140 that year.
So you have made up more than 500 yo-yo tricks.
I'm sitting at about 520 right now.
That might be more yo-yo tricks than existed at that time.
I mean, and it's a quantifiable 500. Like I can send somebody the URLs for all of them. It's pretty crazy. Like it just that number really kind of dawned on me the other day, and I was like, wow, really? I could have been, I don't know, earning money or spending time with my children. Or
we're just about at the end of this segment, but I want you to tell folks about the new project.
The new project is 365cooltricks.com. And instead of just limiting it to yo-yos, I have a ton of interests. I've been, you know, juggling all kinds of object manipulation and stuff. And then I hang out with, you know, narrow little buffoons like these fellas. So what I'm doing is it's going to be the same thing. It's going to be the same kind of trick-a-day project, but it's going to be a wide variety of everything from juggling to card tricks, kendama, stunts you can do with household objects, things like that. But starting, what month is this?
May.
June 1st. 365cooltricks.com. We'll start having one cool trick video, just random trick, every single day.
That's awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Steve Brown.